Hi guys, this is gsnnow.com and I'm here with the LG Optimus G handset, for now the flagship phone from LG before the LG Optimus G Pro takes over the world and arrives in all stores there are out there. So the LG Optimus G with the code name version E975 is only one of the three versions of the phone that are available all over the world, and this is considered the twin brother of the Google Nexus 4 since it has similar specs, a not so different design, and they were launched pretty close, separated by a couple of weeks. The price tag of this handset is €499, free of contract, at least on a carrier like Orange. This handset was announced in August and it was launched in November, so quite a bit of a delay, especially compared with other flagship models that arrived earlier or afterwards if you're talking about the Sony Xperia Z. Let's check out the design of the LG Optimus G. So we've got a waistline of 8.5 millimeters and a weight of 145 grams. It's reasonably thin but also a bit heavy, although you won't feel that when you hold the handset in your hand. At the back, we're supposed to have a glass panel just like the Nexus 4. Although some people have claimed that this is plastic, I tend to believe it's actually glass. If you look carefully at certain angles, under the glass there's a dotted texture and an interesting way to reflect the light. So that's the back side. By the way, around the display of the device you can see that we have a stainless steel frame all around it for extra solidity. It's a very thin stainless steel frame that adds a bit of elegance. This is a wide phone, while the Galaxy S3 was a long phone, was actually a bit longer like this, or taller if you want. This one is actually wider, and I like that because the QWERTY keyboard, the virtual one, is more comfy to use on the LG Optimus G. The handset is completely flat, it doesn't have any curves. The only curves it has are at the edges, so it has rounded corners, and that's all the curving you get on this handset. I have to say that the camera tends to protrude a bit too much from the back, so if you lay the handset flat on a surface, it will tend to drag on the camera and stand out maybe too much from the flat back surface. Okay, at the back we've got the camera, 30 megapixel camera with flash, the LG logo and the speaker available right here. Up front we've got the earpiece right here at the top, front camera, and the sensors, then comes obviously the display, and there are three capacitive buttons below the display, you can see them. We got the back button, home button and menu button right here. On the left side you can see the volume buttons here and the micro SIM card slot discreetly integrated here. On the right side, on off button right here at the top, and finally on the top side we got the audio jack here and a microphone close by here, while at the bottom there's the micro USB port and yet another microphone plus two screws on each side. So overall I consider this design to be a pretty successful one. I like the small edges of the screen, so as you can see you can't really tell where the screen ends and the edge begins, and this is one thing that I like about the LG Optimus G. As far as hardware is concerned, this model offers you a true HD IPS Plus LCD screen with a 4.7 inch diagonal and the resolution of 1280 over 768 pixels, plus a pixel density of 318 ppi. We've got Gorilla Glass 2 protection, and other specs worth mentioning include Dolby Mobile sound. There is no card slot on this device, keep that in mind, there is no micro SD card slot. And as far as memory goes, we have 32 gigabytes, of which 25 are user available. There is also 2 gigabytes of RAM inside this phone. Specifications also include the 13 megapixel camera at the back, as I said earlier, so this is the cam right here with its square frame and LED flash, while at the front we have a 1.3 megapixel camera. Well, inside this handset, powering it up is its brain, a Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 Pro quad-core processor. It's a 1.5 GHz Cryte CPU with a GPU that's an Adreno 320. On the connectivity side, we get 4G LTE HSDPA connectivity with a speed of 42 megabytes per second. There is also Wi-Fi dual band on board, DLNA, Bluetooth 4.0, NFC, micro USB 2.0 with MHL, and there's also an accelerometer, gyroscope, proximity sensor, and a compass. There's also stereo FM radio with RDS, GPS, GLONASS, and this handset comes in a black version, or you can also purchase it in a white version if you want to. Other stuff worth mentioning is the active noise cancelling available on this phone, and it's important to talk about the battery. Well, this handset comes with a non-removable lithium polymer battery with a capacity of 2100 mAh. On paper, this battery provides 456 hours of standby functioning, while the talk time should be about 15 hours of 2G talk time. It has the same battery as the Nexus 4, and in our tests, the battery achieved about 20 hours of use. So it's an impressive time of use, even for this handset, so about 20 hours. Aside from the normal use that will do a bit over a day, you can also activate an eco mode. You can see it right here, the eco mode among the notification area options, and there's also special options here for the eco mode. It's called quad core control. What the eco mode does is to boost the battery life of the phone by alternating between quad core and dual core use. So you simply activate it and the management of the battery will be improved. LG states that the battery inside this phone is 30% more dense than other batteries with the same 2100 mAh capacity. They also said that this battery can last 800 cycles of charging compared to the 500 cycles that other batteries with the same capacity will tend to last. So that's all when it comes to the hardware of the LG Optimus G. As far as the audio is concerned, as you can see here, we have the pair of headphones that comes with the phone. They're actually very comfortable headphones and also pretty nice looking with a unique visual identity associated with the brand. Okay, so now let's put the headphones aside and let's listen to some music on this handset. Okay, I'm going to go to apps, SoundCloud, and listen a bit of Noisia. By the way, comfortable virtual keyboard. And let's search for a certain tune. Here we go, and let's listen to the music. The speaker is right here. Okay, so we have good volume, that's actually huge on the headphones. So if you connect the headphones, you'll see that the bass is very good, the volume is huge. And if you connect these headphones to other devices like an MP3 player or other phones, you'll be impressed by the performance, even if it's not connected to an LG device. Okay, so let's stop the music and draw some conclusion. I liked very much the bass that this handset offers, both the speaker and the headphones. So impressive bass, extraordinary clarity. There is no distortion even at the maximum volume. And now I want to show you, first let's mute it, and then I want to show you the music player that comes with the device. So here's the music player and some of the options that are offered in this case. Okay, so we got this song right here, you start playing it, and then we've got some options that you'll see in a minute. So here are the settings that require you to connect the headphones to benefit from some customization. So headphones on, audio effects available. As you can see, we've got Dolby Mobile, headset enhancer, bass reducer, bass booster, treble booster, vocal booster, and custom. Aside from that, there is a special Dolby option here, Dolby Mobile on right now. So overall, the audio experience is pretty well taken care of. So once again, excellent bass, excellent clarity, no distortion, music player with a couple of interesting settings. There is also FM radio. So let's look for it. Should be here somewhere. Here it is, FM radio. Of course, it requires you to connect the headphones yet again. And this is the interface of the FM radio. You turn it on, start looking for the frequency. And that's about it as far as the radio is concerned. The headphones are very comfortable, keep that in mind. And the audio is superior to the one of the Xperia Z and even the Samsung Galaxy S3. Since we're speaking about the audio side, we might as well address the calls. And this phone is capable of HD voice calls that get excellent volume, and one of the carriers that offers HD voice calls is Orange. So that's about it when it comes to the audio part of this handset review. So let's put the headphones aside and let's analyze the capacity of the display and the video player on this device. We have a special video playing application. You can see here some of our captures, maybe the camera, but I'm more interested in this animation. So we got this big bug bunny animation with vivid colors and a bunch of critters running around. Let's turn up the volume. Okay, so the screen here is a true HD IPS Plus display with impressive performance, as you can see. Just like on last year's LG Optimus 4X HD, you can zoom in by pinching and the image still stays impressive. Aside from zooming in, there's also the function called Q-Slide that is basically just like the pop-up play on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2 and Galaxy S3. You can move the video around the screen and you can also change its transparency, as you can see, making it more or less transparent while you do something else, like check out the weather for the following days. Then you can go back to full screen mode. And other things worth mentioning is the beautiful color that display produces. By the way, the screen on the LG Optimus G, it uses a zero gap technology, and zero gap technology means that the LCD panel is fused with the glass and the pixels seem closer to the surface. So the video capacity is great on this device. By the way, the screen has a pixel density of 318 ppi and the layout is a standard RGB sub-pixel layout. The text is shown in a crisp way and the view angles are excellent. So let's get back to the video and check out the view angles a bit. So as you can see, no problem with the view angles. Okay, other stuff worth mentioning is that the brightness is very good and we're at about 40% right now. Imagine what 100% looks like on this display. The blacks are pretty deep. However, I find that the colors tend to be a bit oversaturated. By the way, the player on this phone supports MP4, DivX, it supports VMV, H.264, and on the audio side it supports FLAC. There's also Miracast streaming to television sets compatible with that standard. And you can also do Q-Slide, that's an interesting thing. So if I go to the browser and enter YouTube, for example, I can do Q-Slide using a YouTube clip. So this is Q-Slide, also working with a YouTube clip. There are various other apps to use Q-Slide with, but it's a nice touch from LG to also implement that on YouTube. Overall, the video capacity of the phone is excellent, the colors are vivid, the screen is bright and the text is very crisp. Okay guys, so now it's time to cover the camera of the LG Optimus G. It's a 30 megapixel camera with LED flash, autofocus and geotagging, face detection, image stabilization and 1080p video capture. So I'm going to use this castle, take a quick snap and show you the options that this camera offers you. There's touch focus obviously here and I'm taking that snap right now. And here's the result. As you can see, indoors the noise level is pretty big, but outdoors the brightness is quite decent. Some would say that the brightness is even too much when taking pictures outdoors. Some interesting options available here in this camera area. One of them is the voice control, so you can say smile, whiskey, cheese, kimchi or LG to take a shot. So let's try it. Smile, whiskey, cheese, you get the idea. Okay, and another interesting feature is the time catch shot is the one that captures the missing moment before pressing the shutter, and it triggers about 4 more frames before you press the shutter, so you'll never miss a moment again. And as you can see, it has taken some more snaps and is displaying the missing moments. Imagine you're at a party and you'll catch everyone with their eyes shut. Well, if you go back in time to the previous frames, you can get the shots where their eyes were not shut. Okay, let's get back to the camera area. Let's see what other options we have. Obviously, we have HDR, panorama, and continuous shot. That's pretty much a burst shot with a different name. Going back to normal. And now, speaking of normal, I'm going to show you the usual options that all handset cameras come with. We got flash options, zoom options. Obviously, you can pinch to zoom. Brightness options, image size, scene modes, with sunset, night, smart shutter included, ISO levels, white balance, color effect, not many of them, timer, geotagging, shutter sound, auto review, and that's about it. Then you can switch to the video capture mode, where some more options await you, like full HD, HD capture, some funny live effects to apply, flash options, and then the rest, white balance, color effect, audio recording, and all that. Pretty simple interface, including the usual HDR, panorama, burst shot, ISO, white balance, and other stuff like that. Now it's time to show you the samples of pictures we actually took outdoors over the past days. So we got a gallery right here, and we've taken more than 100 shots. Let me show you the more colorful ones. You can see that while pictures may seem bright, they're not actually bright. They're actually covered with a white layer for some reason. So they have a whitish hue applied on top of them, a sort of halo. There is a white halo on these pictures that I find to be very strange. You'll also see a full gallery in the text review of the LG Optimus G, but meanwhile, we have some slightly oversaturated colors here. The colors are good, but sometimes the camera tends to exaggerate, especially when it comes to the red. So these red flowers were not actually that red in real life, as you'll see in a video that I'll show you immediately. So I have a video right here that will show you flowers changing colors in real time. So you can see that this flower has been changed. So let me go back and show you again. You just saw that flower becoming even more red as the camera tried to focus, and now you can see other flowers changing colors all of a sudden. So the camera has a hard time actually getting the proper colors, and sometimes the continuous autofocus goes crazy. By the way, the camera will continuously try to focus, and there is not an option to deactivate the continuous focusing. So those are the main problems with the camera. The brightness is okay, the pictures taken outdoors don't experience any kind of noise, good quality, as you can see right here, a lot of level of detail, good contrast. Oversaturation and the white halo are the only problems that this camera has, plus the small autofocus problems. Overall, I can say that the camera is better than the one on the Xperia Z, and especially in one aspect that I'm going to show you immediately, the quality when zooming in, that's a very important aspect. So I had a video of a dog here, here it is. This is a dog, and I will zoom in on him as he lives. While I was testing the Sony Xperia Z, when I zoomed in, the quality was pretty crappy, but when zooming with the LG Optimus G, the quality is better. Also, once the dog is leaving, I will shake the handset a bit, you'll see, and the stabilization is actually pretty decent. So overall, the camera is above the Xperia Z, somewhere between the Xperia Z and the HTC One X. Also, it's below the ASUS Padfone 2 that has the best 13 megapixel camera on a smartphone that I've tested recently. Okay, and now another small thing that I must mention. Let's choose a picture to show you the editing options that we have available. So we got edit right here with a bunch of effects. Posterize, Lomo. Another picture, another bunch of effects. You can also apply some color tweaks. Play with the saturation. Also do some adjustments like straightening, phase glow, flip, sharpen, crop, and fill light, highlights and other ways to play with pictures by editing them. So that's all when it comes to the camera on the LG Optimus G 13 megapixel camera. For those of you who are tech buffs and really want to get to the technical side of it, you should know that this is a 13 megapixel sensor that's on 3.2 inches in size. It's also a BSI sensor and its pixel size is 1.1 microns. We got a 5 element lens with f2.4 aperture. We got continuous autofocus on all the time, and the video captures are taken in 1080p 30 frames per second, and the bitrate is 10.5 megabytes per second, which is not that impressive since the Nokia Lumia 920 has about 20 megabytes per second. Time for the benchmark, folks. Time to evaluate this handset as far as virtual performance in synthetic benchmarks are concerned. Okay, so I decided to compare this quad-core phone, the LG Optimus G, with the quad-core Sony Xperia Z and the quad-core ASUS Padfone 2. After all, they all have the same processor, quad-core Snapdragon S4 Pro. So in quadrant, we scored 7,730 points. We were beat by the Sony Xperia Z, but only by a little bit. That model scored 8,000 points, and the ASUS Padfone 2 was lower than us with 7,600 points. Moving further, we've got AnTuTu with an impressive score of 18,000. We were past the Sony Xperia Z with its 16,000, but we were below the Padfone 2 with its 21,000. Next comes Nenomark with 59.7 frames per second. This one is below the Xperia Z that had 59.9, but above the Padfone 2 that had 58. And then comes Velamo with 1,600 points. We were below the ASUS Padfone 2 with 1,900 points. Finally, we also did a test in the 3D Mark, probably the most relevant test right now. We got a huge score of 10,000 points. The biggest score right now in 3D Mark is 11,000, so this handset is actually very good if we judge by this benchmark. We also tried the extreme benchmark. We got a more modest score of 5,421. So keep that in mind, this handset has an excellent score in 3D Mark for some reason. Of course, the browser test was underwhelming. 1,426 points in Browser Mark 2.0, but that happens all the time, and I tend to believe that this test is irrelevant. Okay, if you're wondering about software, I'm going to show you what operating system this handset has, and that's Android 4.1.2 Jelly Bean with the LG Optimus UI 3.0 on board. This means an array of customization that includes this notification area at the top that can be triggered at all time, and it has a huge amount of sections to show. So we got huge number of toggles here. Of course, you can edit them, change their order and switch them among themselves. So we got airplane mode, power saver, Miracast, hotspot, sync, rotation, Wi-Fi, GPS, Bluetooth, echo mode, NFC, data and quick memo. Quick memo, you probably have seen it before on other devices, so let me show you what it does. As you can see, I already scribbled something. That makes no sense whatsoever. I'm going to use an eraser to wipe it. Basically, when you activate Quick Memo, you can take notes straight on your handset screen. So one moment you're swiping through the screens, the other moment you feel that you have to write something like buy milk. If you have huge hands and you write huge stuff, you won't have room on the screen, but you get the idea. If you have a quick number to jot down, something like a phone number, if you want to 333-4455, and you write someone's number really fast or an address, and you're all set with the notes. You can also change the background if you want to really feel like you're taking notes, and you can also lock the front key in order to only control this area of the screen. So that's it when it comes to the quick memo feature. There's also the list of quick slide applications. You saw earlier the quick slide option for the video player and for the YouTube video in the internet browser. We've got quick slide, we got Q slide for memo as well, for the calendar and for the calculator. You can only get a maximum of two windows open at the same time, but you can alternate between them, change their transparency, move them around. So I can write something in memo really fast, move it around, change the transparency, quickly switch to the other home screens, do something else, once again move the memo around, then play with the calendar. So this is sort of a bit of a multitasking, But sometimes when the transparency is off, you may confuse your Q-Slide applications. Overall, it's a good idea because you can alternate between two tasks like writing a memo, checking out a calendar, or doing a quick calculus on the calculator. And that's about it when it comes to these slide customizations. Now it's time to go deeper into the software experience and really analyze everything that this handset offers, so here we go. We got the widgets right here, some of them classic for the stock Android experience, some of them unique. The photo album, for example, is unique. Smart World from LG, of course, is unique to his phone, task manager, and a few other options. So we got this task manager here that cleans everything up. We got a music player here. So those are the widgets you're dealing with. Multitasking is done by keeping the home button pressed and swiping like I'm doing right now to close all the apps. I must also show you the web browser. Here it is. Let's try to load some other site and then our site, to actually show you how fast this handset can handle loading sites. By the way, this is the virtual keyboard. I was mentioning before that this handset is rather wide than long. The Galaxy S3 is rather longer than wider. And I like a wide phone because it's easier to type with big fingers. Okay, so let me access gsmdom.com. Here we go. Site loaded reasonably fast in spite of the earlier poor result in Browser Mark 2.0. Easy to pinch to zoom, easy to scroll around, and the text is actually crisp and visible even without having to scroll too much, thanks to this True HD IPS screen that we got on the LG Optimus G. Okay, so that was the web browser, and I'm happy with the white display. And you can also customize your icons, so you keep an icon pressed, then this small purple icon appears on top of it, and you can change its pictogram. Pick one of these options, a cute customization options from LG. Now let's see what else. Of course, you can view your home screens like this, personalize them, change your default home screen. And now that moment of the review has come, where I show you some of the apps available on this phone. So for example, we got Backup, that does exactly what the name says. And then we got Dictionary right here. You can download a bunch of languages, search for expression, words. So if I'm searching for sheep, I will also get expressions, and this is the translation from English to German. A bunch of expressions, sentences, and the translation to German. Aside from that, we have Chrome, as you can see right here, but you've probably seen that before. And let me see, we have a notebook feature that some people say it mimics the S Note from the Galaxy Note 2. As you can see, the notebook allows you to create your own special notes with drawing, images, maps, and stickers. So this is the notebook. You start on your note, you select a special cover for it, and then you select the pattern like paper with lines, paper color. And these are the options that you have available. You can also delete pages, you can change the type of text that you have available, you can draw, you can write, you can wipe, you can add a lot of stuff like stickers, images, photos, video, recording video, audio, recording voice, location, date and time. So it's a multimedia note basically, with handwriting, text writing via keyboard, and a ton of other options, just like the S Note from the Galaxy Note 2 that everyone was praising so much. Okay, so let's see what other applications we have available here. There's one called Remote Call, where LG will aid you with all the problems that you have on this device. And aside from Remote Call, you have Safety Care. This one allows you to get some emergency call forwarding and the phone non-usage notice. For example, if you have a bad heart and the phone senses you're not using it for a long time, it can call the special emergency number and have you rescued from your heart attack, God forbid, or other problems like that. And then we have a function called Smart Share. It allows you to share content via DLNA. And let's see what else. Of course, there's Smart World. This is the LG App Store. Every big company that makes an Android phone nowadays has its own application store, with top free apps, top paid apps, new applications, a special HD zone, Brand Zone, LG Special. It's quite a cute interface if you ask me. They really done a fine job this time. They updated the App Store not so long ago. I won't show you the calendar, maps and Gmail apps since they're pretty basic, but I'm going to show you an interesting feature. I'll be right back with the book. Here we go. We got this book right here and I'm going to perform some translation using an application called Quick Translator. So here we go, I'm going to use the camera, try to translate some of the words from this book. So you can translate either by block, word or line. Let's try a word first. It's translating from Romanian to English in real time. And then after translating a word, you can translate a line. You can also share it with other people if you want. And then you can translate a whole block of text. It's taking a longer while, but in the end, of course, there are some problems with the results. It may skip some words, but for now it's a nice experiment that someday may prove useful in other mediums. And continuing our stroll among application, we got a task manager here that will stop all the application. You can also uninstall app, check out the storage and see some default options. Aside from task manager, we got an application called Tasks, where you activate a new task or you can sync your tasks with Microsoft Exchange. Here you can set a subject, start date, due date, description, priority and other stuff like that. So you can see your appointment in the tasks on your other handsets synced to Exchange, which is a pretty cool feature. Okay, so we also got a feature here for video editing. Most handsets nowadays come with a simple video editor like this one. But for some reason, LG decided to include one more video editor. I don't know why they did that. So, lucky us, we get to play with two video editors. So you can select the style of the video is. We got dynamic, pump it up, like a music video, dice, showreel, sentimental, showcase. Let's try the showcase. Then you can select the music. And then you can select the images and videos. Those are the images that I have available that I've already filmed or taken photos outside, screenshots. So I'm going to choose a video and a picture. It's annoying that it takes a long while to load, but it's my fault. I actually have 200 pictures in here and a lot of videos. So let's try to choose an image. So we got two images, like this one, and videos over here. We got this one, and we got this one. Let's see what the result is. You can also add some more options like text, a sticker. You can also trim. So there are a lot of options to play with here. But let's just see the result for now. And there appears to be an error. Such things tend to happen in the world of Android. So welcome to Android, folks. It happens sometimes that problems like this appear. Okay, here we go again. We have to select the music, default for this style. So let's go again. It's actually rendering in real time. That may be the reason why it reset on us earlier. It's a pretty fun way to edit your holiday video, but not any professional video, so don't start dreaming about that. Okay, that was VideoWiz, and that pretty much ended our list of applications to check out. Obviously, we also have weather, but you find that on other handsets as well. One last thing, I'm going into the settings area, because I want to show that in the display area, we have a feature called Smart Screen. It does pretty much what the Samsung Smart Stay does. It may not work when your eyes are not facing the camera. Anyway, the idea is that the screen will stay open as long as your eyes are watching it. And also, if this feels like a Samsung copy, well, it may be considered that way. We also have some gesture options for flipping the phone to silence incoming calls or pause videos. And then there's another copied feature, if I can say so, in the sound area. It's called Quiet Time. Basically, it's a Do Not Disturb feature from iOS. It's exactly the same thing. And another copied thing, that sound that it makes when you activate the lock screen is a lot like Samsung's TouchWiz on the Galaxy S3 and its similar water drop sound. Okay guys, it's the end of the review, time for the pros, cons and verdict. This is the LG Optimus G and the pros are it's nice design, but it's a matter of taste. Some people will hate this design, some people will love the design. So once again, it's a matter of tastes. I like the design, so I put it in the pros area. It's got excellent audio, both the speaker and those nice headphones. It's got very good viewing angles, nice brightness, a bit of oversaturated colors, a good GPU and CPU combo that looks great in video games. The price is not that bad actually. We got a good battery with 20 hours of functioning time. And the screen once again is very good. We got those unique cool features from LG, like the quick memo, like the Q-Slide, and this Q-Slide application, that dictionary, the quick translator, all of these gimmicks that make the handset more appealing. On the bad side, we have oversaturated colors on the screen and in the video capture and photo capture. The camera is a bit underwhelming. The interfacing software seems borrowed from Samsung at times, especially those features from earlier. We don't have a micro SD card slot, that is a bummer. The continuous camera autofocus is also a bit of a problem. And finally, the handset may feel slippery and a bit glossy, a bit too glossy. Now it's time to grade it. So the LG Optimus G gets from gsndom.com the grade 8.7 for design and 9 for hardware and 9 for user interface and operating system. Total grade is 8.9 out of 10 from gsndom.com and this is the LG Optimus G. For now, it's a flagship from LG, but another flagship will be coming soon. That's it from us. Bye-bye.